Hey y'all, I'm back with another video. This is going to be a weekly Divine Feminine spread. Okay, so this is for Earth Signs today. We about to do this. But you guys, subscribe to the channel if you aren't ready. Subscribe. Show me some love. Like the video. Comment. And all that goodness, okay? Let's get right into the spread. This is for Earth Signs, Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn, Divine Feminines. This is a Divine Feminine spread for Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn, okay? Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus signs. So if you want to get more insight on your situation with your masculine, I'll be posting masculine videos too if you want to cross-watch for them. Also, check your Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus sign so you can get more information to see your situation if it applies, okay? What mistress do you have for my Earth sign? Divine Feminine. What is the current energy of the Divine Feminine's relationship with her masculine currently? How does the Divine Feminine feel about her masculine currently? How does the masculine feel about the Divine Feminine? What is the challenges that they're facing? What is the outcome? I'm gonna play some music. I'm sorry. I need to hear some music. What is the overall energy of my Earth signs? Divine Feminines. How do they feel about their masculine? How does their masculine feel about them? What is the challenge that they're facing currently? And what is the outcome? Okay, this is for Earth signs, so we're going to do Taurus. Yeah, we're going to do Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn. Taurus, Divine Feminine. Did I see y'all get two collects for this? Because this is a new spread. Like, I'm just trying to, like, figure out. I wrote these. I stayed up all night last night trying to come up with some new spreads. I think I say y'all get one card for this. Yeah. All right. Overall energy, how y'all feel? Challenges gets to play. The outcome. The bottom of the deck, we got the Ten of Swords for Taurus. Let's see what your advice. We'll do the advice portion at the end. Alright, so basically, the current energy that you guys have in this relationship is the Ten of Swords, okay? The Ten of Wands. So basically, y'all both is burdened by this relationship, all right? The way that you feel about your divine masculine, divine feminine, is the Page of Swords, okay? So you want to communicate with your masculine. You want to talk to him. You're just ready to communicate with him. Maybe you guys aren't in union. The way that your masculine feels about you is the Nine of Cups. Okay, and this is for the Taurus divine feminine, okay? So if you're not in a twin flame relationship, this can also apply to you if you're in the soulmate relationship or a partnership with a person that you feel really strongly about, okay? But I say divine feminine and divine masculine because we are divine feminines and divine masculines, okay? So the way that your divine masculine feels about you is the Nine of Cups. So he looks at you like you are his wish, okay? And you just want to communicate with him. So, you want to talk to him. So that's telling me that y'all not in separation. Y'all in separation right now. And he looks at you like you fulfill his wishes. Like you is his wish fulfillment. But the overall energy of your relationship is a burden. So I don't know what's going on with the burden. Y'all got the Ten of Swords at the bottom of the deck. So I'm assuming that, there was some type of betrayal. Okay. And I just seen communication. Somebody is hesitating, on a collaboration, with this Three of Coins and this Nine of Wands. Somebody hesitating on a collaboration. And that's probably why it's a burden, okay? But somebody ultimately got to give in. You got to give in and surrender, okay, so that y'all can communicate again with this communication card, okay? And that's probably why you're feeling like you want to just go and communicate with him. I mean, he looks at you like you his wishes fulfilled. But right now, we got the Ten of Swords at the bottom of the deck. Okay, so let's see what's challenging y'all. The challenge is y'all got Death, and then y'all got the Magician. Okay, so you could be dealing with a Scorpio or somebody that got Scorpio in their chart. You could be dealing with an air sign, Aquarius. And I say air sign because we got the Page of Swords. And we got the Magician, which is the Aquarius. Okay. So you can definitely deal with air sign or somebody with air in that chart. Or somebody that has Scorpio, Cancer, or Pisces in that chart. Okay. Particularly Scorpio. All right. And you'll have some wands here. Somebody probably got fire sign in their chart too. Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. Or you've been dealing with, So basically, what's the challenges is, with you Taurus, Divine Feminine, the challenges in your situation is the Death card. And we have the Magician, okay? So we have two tens here. Well, we have one ten, and then we have the Death. So that's like an ending to something. And somebody is manifesting an ending. So it's looking like this is you, Divine Feminine, that's feeling burdened by your masculine. Either you feeling like your masculine had betrayed you. And it's too much. He putting all these swords in your back and it's too much on you. And that's the ride. The overall energy of the relationship is that you're being burdened. And you want to have a conversation with him. You want to talk to him about it. You want to communicate with him. Okay, but like I said, remember what I had pulled, but you being hesitating. You're hesitating on the communication. You hesitate on this communication, because you don't know if you want to collab with him. It could be another person in this situation. Okay. And listen, I cannot make this up. Look. Somebody is giving it to people. Okay, I don't know who it is, but you want to have a conversation with him about this, you know, situation. I know y'all hear Usher singing this. I'm telling y'all. So basically, yeah, it's two people in this relationship. It's too much going on. And you have to surrender. Like, you want to give in or give up. You want to throw in the towel. You want to communicate, but you hesitating because you want to throw in the towel about collaborating with him because somebody probably else is in the picture. See? Somebody else is probably in the picture. You want to tell him that. You really do. And the person could be an Aries, okay? But, yeah, it could be an Aries. Okay? But you just want to end it. And this is coming from the Divine Feminine's side. She wants to end it. He's looking like this is his wish. Okay? So you could be seeing somebody else on the side. That's what I'm looking at. And you ready to end this. You ready to put it to an end and you want to communicate that to him. That's going to hurt his heart, girl. But, you know, it's all right. And the outcome, we got the Page of Wands, okay? So, basically, you know, you want to end this. You're trying to manifest the ending. That's the challenge. Like, it needs to end. Y'all have to end this, okay? So that y'all can discover something new with each other. That's the only way. It gotta end so that y'all can discover something new with each other. You know, and you'll be able to drop all these burdens that you're carrying because it's too much. It's too much. But he don't feel the burden though. Like, he really don't. Okay. Let's do the advice. Oh. Called to slip right out. Attraction. It says, you attract romantic love by enjoying this moment fully. This is how he's feeling. He's very much attracted to you. Okay. And you attracted to him. What advice do you have for the Taurus Divine Feminines? Holy Spirit. Okay. And you got retreat. I'm saying it's time to disconnect from the world. So basically, yeah, an ending has to happen. Okay. I mean, normally retreat would be like you two going together and retreating and spending some time alone. But in this case, it has to end so that you can drop all these burdens. You need some time to think. Okay. It has to be an ending so that you could go in and think. You have to go in and think so that you guys can discover something new with each other, either with each other or separately, okay? But y'all will come back around to each other because he clearly thinks that you his Nine of Cups, okay? His wish fulfillment. Another card flipped over. Which one was it? Here you go. And then we got release your ex, okay? So it says, this time has come. This time has come to clear your energy. Yeah. You have to retreat. You have to release. You want to have this conversation, okay? Either you're dealing with somebody else on the side and you have to let go. Okay, if you're dealing with somebody else on the side that you have to let go. And it's telling you to release your ex because I did see a third person here. Okay? And you want to have a conversation with your with your masculine, okay, letting him know, you know, that you're giving up, you know, and you want to communicate that to him, you know, as soon as possible. But you hesitate to do so because you see, you hesitating to do so because you know that you light up his life. You know that you are the one you know, that you make him happy, but you just don't see it with him no more because you're burdened by it. You're burdened, and that's why the challenges is the death card and the magician. Yeah. So you need to release him and retreat and go within, okay? So that you can be with somebody that you're more attracted to, okay? And you, and the outcome, like I said, is you're going to be discovering something new. Somebody new, okay? So, that was for Taurus, okay? The Taurus Divine Feminine. Next, we're going to do... Yeah, you're torn. Like I should say, your heart is in two different places. And that's the burden. Okay? That's the burden. You want somebody else. You don't want the masculine. You want somebody else. Okay, Taurus, who's next? Virgo. What message do you have for the Virgo Divine Feminine? What message do you have for the Virgo Divine Feminine? What is the overall current energy of their relationship? How does the Divine Feminine feel about her masculine? How does the masculine feel about the Divine Feminine? What are the challenges? And what is the outcome? Yeah, I wanna say thank you for being in my life. I wanna say thank you. Ace of Cups. And I wish you were here with me. Manifestation was current energy. And you hear the song, you wishing him back. You love him. Listen. Let me play it loud. That's Ashanti. Okay. So for the Virgo Divine Feminines, the overall current energy of your relationship is the Magician, okay? So you're trying to manifest something, okay? You're trying to manifest something in this relationship, okay? The way that you feel about your, the way that you feel about your divine masculine is the Three of Cups, okay? So, you feel like celebrating with your masculine, or for some of y'all, Virgo, Divine Feminines, you're cheating on your masculine. The way that the masculine feels about you is the Ten of Swords. He feels betrayed. Okay, he feels betrayal. The challenges y'all facing in the situation is the Nine of Wands, somebody being hesitant, and the Four of Swords, so somebody being hesitating, and they trying to just clear their mind of the situation. Okay. At the bottom of the deck, we got the World. So basically, with the World, that means that it's just going to be new cycles, okay? It's time for a change. And that's why y'all going into rest right now, okay? Because the outcome is contemplating, okay? Meditating with this Four of Cups. You're contemplating and meditating,
somebody contemplating and meditating, I think it's you. So the way that you feel about your masculine is that you might feel that he's in a relationship with somebody else, but I want to clarify this, okay? Yeah. Or you feel really happy with your masculine with this Ten of Cups at the top of the deck. You feel like this person is the alternate person that you love. You know, you really love this person. You know, we got the Page of Cups. You've been meditating for this person. You've been praying for this person. This is the person that you want. That's why the overall energy is the Magician. Because you've been trying to manifest him. You've been praying for him to come. Okay? You love him. You love this person. You feel happy. You want to celebrate with him and all that. But for some reason, he feels like there's a betrayal. Yeah. You went, and you have the Ace of Coins. You want to offer him. You want to make an offer to him. A new beginning. And you want to collaborate. You want to collaborate with him. But the three came again. So there's a third party. Okay? There's a third party. Yeah. You want to collaborate with him. And you want to have victory with him. And you want things to change in the situation between the two of you. Okay? You want things to change. And you're trying to manifest that because you love him. Let me see. Why is the Ten of Swords here for the masculine? It's feelings. Why is the Ten of Swords here for the Virgo divine masculine's feelings? Here we go. The Knight of Cups. He says betrayed because either you flirted with somebody else or you made a romantic gesture to somebody else. Or he offered his love to somebody else. And he was being sneaky. Okay? With the Seven of Swords at the bottom. So, you love him. But you know that he's in a third party situation with somebody. But you love him. You want to collaborate with him. You want to offer him, like I said, you want to offer him a new opportunity. You know, you want to make a new offer to him. You manifested him. You was praying for him. You meditating and praying that he come back, you know, or that he get his shit together. But, you know, the way that he feels right now is that he feels like either you betrayed him by offering your romance to somebody else, or he feels like he betrayed you and offering his romance to somebody else. So currently right now, you know, y'all hesitating to make shit work. And y'all just resting and trying to figure out what it is that y'all want to do. And the outcome is, you know, the Four of Cups. You know, meditating. Meditating and thinking. So y'all have a lot to think about in the situation. You know, whether or not you want to keep on manifesting this or not. Okay, because somebody being sneaky, you trying to on some shady stuff, and I think it's him or it could be you. You know, yeah, we got the King of Swords. So you could be dealing with an Aquarius, or I don't know, I always say Aquarius, because first of all, I'm an Aquarius, so that's like the first thing that comes to my mind when I see the King of Swords. But because we have the Magician here, it's overall energy and the King of Swords, you could be dealing with an Aquarius, okay? And then also, either you could be cold to him or, you know, the outcome is that you're going to have to go into meditation, okay, and contemplate and think, and it's causing somebody to be cold towards the other one, okay? It's causing somebody to be emotionless to the other person. And you could be dealing with an Aquarius, like I said, or you could be dealing with a water sign, okay, or somebody that has water in their chart, or somebody that has air in their chart, okay. So that was for Virgo, Divine Feminines. Next, who's at the Virgo? Capricorn. Hold up. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, yeah.
Sagittarius, I love all you.
Holy Spirit, what messages do you have for my Capricorn divine feminine?
Capricorn, Aquarius, Pisces, Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Cancer.
It's crazy that this song came on while I was doing a reading for the zodiac sign. Crazy. And I'm like, hold up, what sign are we on again? I sing this song when I'm trying to remember the damn zodiac sign. No lie. So now y'all know my little secret. What messages do you have for my, this thing keep on popping up on my screen. What messages do you have, Holy Spirit, for my, Capricorn divine? Feminines. What is the overall challenges in their relationship? What is overall energy in their relationship? Oh, I forgot to do, hold up a second. I forgot to do the advice for Virgo. Hold up a second. I'll do your advice, Virgo, at the end, okay? I'm so sorry. So, in fact, I'm going to do it right now. Hold up. I'm going to do it right now. Holy Spirit, but, oh, damn, you caught this one to fly out. It says, worth waiting for. It says, divine timing is at work in your love life, okay? So you're manifesting that situation, okay? And even though there was some type of betrayal, you know, because somebody was offering a cup to somebody else, you're doing a great thing by going in and contemplating and thinking, okay? And resting your mind about it. But ultimately, the person is worth waiting for. What other messages do you have? What advice do you have for my Virgo? What advice do you have for the Virgo divine feminines? There were so many cards I wanted to flip over, but I like to have a grip on my cards. These are slippery. Here go, boy. Retreat. You guys got retreat too, okay? And that's exactly what y'all doing. Y'all retreating, going in, contemplating, and meditating on what it is that you really want out of this relationship so that, you know, you guys can gain some type of balance in a relationship, okay? Let's see. You have any other messages from my Virgo divine? Here we go. And then some of y'all got new love, so y'all going to be contemplating and thinking about whether or not you're just going to just end that situation altogether, okay? It says a new person has stirred your romantic feelings. So basically, like I said, there was a third person in that situation, okay? There was a third person in that situation, divine feminine. And, you know, it's looking like you may want to collaborate with somebody else, but you're contemplating thinking about what it is that you want to do, okay? Because your divine masculine felt, you know, betrayed and backstabbed because somebody offered that cup, you know, a romance to somebody else. So, you know, I mean, it is what it is, you know. If you found somebody else that you're looking for and you're contemplating and thinking about what it is that you want to do, but some of y'all is going to be reconciling if you're in that situation. Y'all could be reconciling with the masculine, okay? And some of y'all is going to go towards that new love. So that was for the Virgos. Okay, next. Now we on Capricorn now. What is the overall energy of the current relationship with the Capricorn Divine Feminines. How does the Divine Feminine feel about her masculine? How does the masculine feel about the Capricorn Divine Feminine? What are the challenges that they're facing? And what is the outcome of their situation?
It's all right, yes.
Ooh.
Oh, oh, yeah. I wanna feel you, girl.
Okay, so the overall energy at the bottom of the deck is the Wheel of Fortune, okay? So, that's good luck. Looking at what I see here, that would be good luck. That would be considered good luck for me. The current energy of your situation right now is strength, okay? So, both of y'all are...
Some of the hardest things to do in life...
Well, your Divine Feminine is... You know, basically, trying to have strength, holding a relationship together, okay? The way that you feel about your masculine is the Sun. So, you feel very happy about your masculine. You know, you're very happy and, you're just full of light. You just have a lot of, you feel really good about him. Really good, okay? The way that your masculine feels about you is the Page of Swords, okay? So, your masculine could want to have a conversation with you, okay? He could be immature. He could feel that you're immature. But we're going to clarify, okay? So, the challenges that we have is the Lovers. Okay, we got the Lovers. And we have the Three of Pentacles, okay? So, the challenges is that you guys just aren't coming together. I mean, you aren't seeing eye to eye on something. The challenge is that you guys some of y'all the challenge is that y'all you love the person and you want to work together with them. But it's something else going on, okay? Some of y'all, you in love with this person, but they got somebody else, okay? But y'all got the Wheel of Fortune, so y'all got the good luck on your side, and that's why it's calling for y'all to have strength. Let's see. Yeah, and the Star card, and have hope. Okay, this is clarifying strength, actually. You could be dealing with a Leo, a Gemini, an air sign, an Aquarius, okay? Or a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Any sign, really. I got all the signs out here. Let's see. Why is this Three of Pentacles here? Ooh. All these cards going to come out. Why is this Three of Pentacles here for the Capricorn Divine Feminine and her challenges and her situation with her Divine Masculine? Why is this Three of Pentacles here? Why is this Three of Pentacles here? The magician wanted to come out. Some of y'all are trying to manifest a successful situation with your lover. You want to collaborate with him. You're trying to manifest that. Some of y'all are dealing with air signs, specifically Aquarius. I keep saying that. And this is for the Capricorn. Yeah, the magician came back out again. See, because I seen at the bottom of the deck, and then I'm like, okay, yeah. You want to manifest the challenges is the lovers, the Three of Pentacles, and then the magician is clarifying the Three of Pentacles, okay? So you're trying to manifest that you guys can work together, okay? Or you're trying to, or he could be in a relationship with somebody else. This can be different situations. You're trying to manifest this, manifest that he's not in a situation with somebody else, or you're trying to manifest the fact that y'all two need need to work together more in harmony, okay? And that's why I'm thinking that this person must be in a relationship with somebody else. And you're trying to manifest, you know, if y'all not having harmony in your relationship, that's why it's causing y'all to have, it's telling y'all to have strength and hope, okay? Have hope and have the strength. Because, you know, he could be immature, you know, and that's probably why y'all not working together or collaborating together the way that you should. But you feel happy. You know, you feel happy about him. But at the bottom of the deck, we do have the devil, okay? So that's just a lot of unhealthy things, you know, that's taking place with the two of you right now, okay? And that's why you have to have strength and you have to have strength and you have to have hope, okay? Let me see. Why is this page? I'm going to see why he feel like the page. Why is this page of why is this Page of Swords here for the way that the Divine Masculine of the Capricorn feminine? Why is the Divine Masculine why is this Page of Swords here, please? For the way that the Divine Masculine feels about the Capricorn Divine Feminine. Yeah, maybe he needs to communicate more. Maybe he feels like you need to communicate more. You know, maybe he's been immature, holding back his, you know, not speaking up. And you just want, you know, things to even out. I mean, I know that three isn't even, but you want... you want him to, you want to work together with him, basically. You want everything to be, you know, an even playing field. You want to work together more with him. Why is this Page of Swords here? Yeah, the Two of Coins. You want balance. You want balance. He wants to communicate that to you, actually. He wants to communicate that he wants things to even out between the two of you. Okay? But with this Page of coins here at the bottom, he doesn't know. He's trying to figure out how to communicate that to you, okay? So he may be coming off as a little bit immature, or he wants, or he feels like you may be coming off as a little bit immature, and he's trying to figure out how can he say this to you. Okay. And for the outcome, we got the Four of Wands, okay? So there's a celebration or marriage to be, you know, had. You know, keep on manifesting. Okay, this is y'all meant to be together. Y'all got this, y'all got, and y'all got the Lovers. Come on now. You know this is a partner, you know, a meant to be partnership. So, let's see what y'all advice is. You guys got true love. It says this is the romance of a lifetime, Capricorn. This is your romance. Listen to what Beyonce is singing. You got me speechless.
You got me speechless.
Yes. All right. Let's see, what other advice do we have for the Capricorn Divine Feminines? Yeah, they're basically saying this is your true love. Here go another one. And then forgiving and learning, it says, as you release and heal your past, you experience more love in your present moments, okay? So, yeah, some of you guys need to heal. And the sun is about healing, too, okay? So, you can feel, you can be feeling happy, but you can also be feeling like you need to heal, okay? That's why the overall energy is the strength. Some of y'all need to heal, okay? And have faith and hope, okay? Because y'all are in the process of healing. But ultimately, you guys are destined to be together, okay? There could have been a third party in the mix of y'all situation. But ultimately, like, y'all meant to be together, okay? And keep manifesting this love. Keep manifesting trying to work together with this person, okay? Because he wants to communicate that he wants balance too, okay? Or he wants to communicate to you that he's juggling somebody else. But either way, whatever story resonates with you, you know, you have to have balance, okay? You have to have balance. Because even though this is two people's stories or however you look at it, you know, this is the end result, okay? To a marriage, a celebration, okay? And you have to forget the person in order for y'all to move on to this marriage, okay? Because see, this person is your true love. But that was for Capricorns. Okay, so guys, if you like the video, please like the video, comment, give me feedback, let me know if, you know, if you like these type of videos, if I should continue to do it this way or not, also, if this didn't resonate with you, or if you want more information about your situation, check your sun, moon, rising, and Venus sign videos. I'm going to be posting those up soon. Also, I'm going to be doing the same thing for the Divine Masculine so you can get an insight on what the Divine Masculine is going through and what he's thinking about as well, okay? From his perspective, if you want to cross-watch. So don't forget to like the video, share the video, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next video.